Hey, we're the Zolas, and you're watching the Permanent Rain Press. My friends are wild.
From the Permanent Rain Press. I'm here with the guys from the Zolas. So real quick, you guys introduce yourselves and what you do in the band.
My name's Cody and I play the drums.
I'm Zach, I sing and play guitar.
Tom, keyboard player.
I'm DJ and I do not play the turntables.
His name's DJ, he is not a DJ. And it needs to be made clear.
Okay. So how's your day been so far?
Great, good, yeah.
Staying warm, I hope.
Oh yeah, it was nice today.
It's cold right now though.
Yeah,
Cody did the weather today on the radio.
I heard that on the podcast.
Oh yeah,
how did I do? Are you convinced?
No.
You did sound full of crap.
Well, I was.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the new EP. It came out a couple weeks ago. It's called Wino Oracle.
Mm.
Can you tell me a little bit about the name and the story behind it? How it relates to the album?
Wino Oracle is like that person that we, it's a lyric from the song I Fell in Love with New York, and the first time we went to New York, we noticed that there is like, on the subway in New York, there is every type of person you could possibly meet. I mean, rich people and poor people all take the subway in. So you have like models who like don't get out of bed for less than $10,000, and you have, like junkies and winos, like guys who just drink wine all the time, and I just like the idea of like one of that person who's babbling on the side of a at the end of your subway car, but if you actually listen to what they're saying, they're actually kind of telling the truth. Just thought it was a cool word, Wino Oracle.
So how do you feel it relates to the album?
It fits really well in the song, I don't think it really relates to the album that well at all. I think it's just like good words. I liked it. We went with it. Our next album, man, I don't know. Sometimes you just like a name and you just name your album that. It doesn't have to make sense.
So what made you guys want to put out the EP instead of your album that's coming out later?
Someone else want to take that?
Kind of a technical question. The album wasn't totally done. It's finished now, like as of this week, but we wanted to put something out. We wanted to do this tour that we just did, where we went to Germany and New York and played Canada. So we wanted to put out a couple songs so we could play them and tour those. So some of it's just like timing, and now it's just physically like we have to make albums and get them out and get them ready. So now that it's done, that'll come out early next year, the full length. But so the EP is a bit of a taste of what's to come on the album.
Okay. So do you think it's easier to write an EP or an album?
Well, an EP is great, because you don't have as many songs.
But do you feel limited, or...?
Well, no, I like that. That would be great.
Yeah.
Spend more time on each song, I guess.
That's how we made this album anyway. We just did it in 3-song chunks. Like, when we started recording, we didn't have an entire album of music. And we just had 3 songs that we liked, and we went to the studio and recorded those, and then wrote some more, had another 3 songs, went in the studio and recorded those, and it just means that you're recording songs when you're at your peak of enthusiasm for those songs, which is so much nicer than writing like 12 songs, the first of which you wrote like a year and a half earlier, 2 years earlier, and now you're finally recording it, but you're kind of over it, and that it's nice that that doesn't happen. It's sort of feels like it in keeping with how people consume music right now, and we consume music, where I kind of want to hear what someone was making, you know, last month. I don't need to hear what they're going to make last year.
So kind of talking about that, you guys released Ancient Mars a couple years back. How does it feel to finally have new music out?
Feels great.
Yeah, we're playing lots of new stuff. Lives we're playing. Mm-hmm. Most of the tunes on the EP, and we've been playing a few songs already off the album that's not even out yet.
Okay, cool. So you two, Tom and Zach, have been together for a while. How do you guys manage to keep off of each other's nerves?
I don't know.
They
don't, I guess.
Yeah, that's my first question. Do we? I think
just like mutual respect.
Yeah. I don't think we piss each other off, really. Someone asked me that question. Mm. We just got back from tour. What it's like. And we kind of were hinting at that, like, do you guys, like,
yep.
get in each other's face or whatever. I was just like, no, we just don't really piss each other off.
No.
Well,
if
anything,
it's just like someone does something that you don't like, you're not going to flip on each other. Like, we're all just be like, well, that was annoying, but we're not going to, like, get over it. Like,
yeah,
you know.
We all know we're going to be in a band.
Yeah, like,
it's
inevitable. It's, like, with anyone that you have a relationship with, like, you hang out with someone long enough, you're just like, it could be, like, walking, and you're just like, I hate the way they walk. Like, there's nothing, like, it's just, but you get over it because you're buds, you know, we're all pals, so.
Yeah. What's your favorite thing about Canada or being Canadian?
Wow.
Universal healthcare. Pretty proud of that.
That's pretty useful.
That's pretty tight.
Yeah.
It's come in handy a few times. And it's the kind of thing that, like, all Canadians should be defending with their lives.
Our environment's really beautiful. Like,
yeah.
Especially living in BC,
yeah.
Obviously it's so gorgeous out here.
Yeah. We're pretty spoiled, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We have so much space, you know?
Yeah.
If you want to get away, like, 45 minutes or an hour, you can just be in the middle of nowhere.
Up a mountain. No one can hear you scream.
So healthcare, landscapes,
yeah,
and just, like, overall, like, chillness.
Overall,
people.
Good craft beer.
Good
and
beer.
Just to rate this.
And beers, yeah. Beers.
So since you guys are from Vancouver, you must be used to our rain. What's your favorite rainy day activity?
Scrabble. Scrabble and a good chai.
I don't think I noticed the rain that much. Like,
no.
Someone said, oh yeah, someone was whining about it to me today. Oh yeah, it's raining today. I was like, is it? Like, I don't know.
Yeah,
you just go outside.
Yeah.
Gotta get a rain jacket. Sack
yeah.
up, you know?
But it's really crappy out. I work, like, the studio that I work at is attached to my house, so I actually don't have to go outside. I can go, like, 3 or 4 or 5 days sometimes without actually going outdoors. So if it gets really bad, then I just bunker down.
I spend a lot of time in the rain. When I'm not rocking and rolling, I work outside, so I experience the weather quite a lot. Yeah.
When I'm gone.
All right, so if you could describe yourself as an ice cream flavor, which would you be and why?
How about this? Can we attribute ice cream flavors to each other? I think that'll be more fun.
Yeah.
I think we have to pick one another, so you can't.
I pick Cody right away. He's Tiger Tail.
Yes.
Oh.
I have Tiger Tail in my head right on. Why, Zach?
He's orange. He's black licorice. Two things you would never imagine working out together, and yet, like, that once they swirl, you can't have enough.
Okay.
Okay. Good one.
Cool. Thank you. Respect.
Good one.
Zach.
Yeah.
You're vanilla.
That is the biggest diss. Next.
Where do you go from that?
Next.
Who's left? DJ.
Cotton candy.
You're not that sweet.
No, but
you're
good at
sweet.
First, and then all of a sudden you just, like.
You're sick of it.
No, you just, like, kind of melts in your mouth, and
yeah.
It's just like, yeah, it's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
You're a chocolate frosty, DJ.
Nice.
A chocolate frosty.
Wendy's chocolate
frosty.
With fries in it.
Yeah, when you dip fries.
Nice.
Yeah. 2 a.m. frosty.
Can't eat the burger.
I don't actually think you're vanilla. I just thought it'd be
funny.
It was
a good diss.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cody, you're on Tom.
Tom is, I'd say you're like, I tried this flavor recently, like Earl Grey ice cream. So you're like,
thank you. That's also kind of
very,
this.
Very delicious, but also very respectable and, like, refined, you know?
Yeah, I think it goes with the
yeah.
car, it goes with the car together.
Yeah, like, look at his vibe, like, he's a,
yeah.
he's done up, man, he's looking good. And he's got great taste, so, like the ice cream.
Alright, so one last question, what's next for you guys?
This is the last of a long string of shows, and then tomorrow we get to do whatever we want, and then the next day we start putting together the, like, nuts and bolts of actually releasing the album. So it's all recorded, but we have to, there's a lot of other stuff that we get involved with, all the artwork, we get involved with, I'm my eyes are glazing over even talking about it. I hate it. I hate it. about all the bullshit, but we have to do that. What else are we gonna do?
Listen to a guy pile ice into a bucket.
Right? Yeah, that should be filling your audio right now.
And we're gonna ice rink so you can listen to ice all the time.
He's never, he doesn't not know how to pile ice quietly.
It'd be better if you just like stacked the cubes like Jenga style right
what
now.
What do they need to keep cold next door? Like, what is that?
It's for this, man. It's for our beers.
Wow, it's for like the well beers.
I like this massive venue that we're at right now.
Thank you guys.
Great.
Thanks a lot. That's it, we're all good. Cool.
You're always around.